Good, great. I've met most of you. I'm Sarah, for those of you that I haven't met. So happy to see you all making yourselves comfortable. It's great. I'm going to do something a little bit different today. I think I told you last time that I've been playing around with toning a lot as a way to get grounded in the body, so sound, vibration in the body specifically. I went to a retreat probably like 10 years ago, and really neat retreat. It was all about using sound vibration to help you cope with difficult emotions. So in this certain cosmology, there's for example, there's this energy called Vajra energy, and it can present as unskillful. In the unskillful way, it can present as anger, okay? The kind of anger that we spew onto other people. Sorry, my headset's giving me trouble today. There we go. But you can transform this energy. So I'm sure you've all had the experience where you're really angry, but if you give it time to calm down, then sometimes you can see really clearly. The energy of anger can actually be like, Vajra literally means diamond knife. So there's a way we can transform these energies, because emotions are not a problem, right? It's when we block the emotions or resist them. We don't allow ourselves to feel that emotions can become a problem. Anyway, that's a lot of words for something that you don't even need to understand necessarily, but it's kind of cool, so I thought I'd explain it. So the energy for Vajra is actually E. That's the seed syllable. So why don't we just all make that sound in a moment? Let's breathe in. And again, if you want to sit up straight or stand, whichever you want, or lay down, that's fine too. The whole point is to feel the vibration of the vowel in your body, okay? So see where you feel the E. Maybe close your eyes. And again, it's not about how the sound comes out or how it sounds. It's about you feeling the vibration in your own body, okay? And the reason I'm doing this at the beginning instead of at the end, like I usually do, is I've realized in my own practice that toning before meditating can really bring us into our bodies, and it can bring energies into balance in a way that can make sitting a lot easier. It's kind of like a shortcut. You know, people will use yoga asana to get their mind calm. So that's a shortcut, right? Breathing in certain ways, pranayama, certain types of breathing, those are shortcuts. The yogis figured out thousands of years ago, like, the shortcuts. So why don't we use them? Instead of like banging our heads against a wall trying to sit still and keep our minds calm, it just doesn't work. Okay, so anyway, so we're gonna breathe in all together, and when we breathe out, you're gonna make the E sound, okay? So in. This next one, breathe into the belly. So maybe actually even put your hands on your belly, and when you breathe in, you want your belly to push outwards. Challenge you a little bit to allow your eyes to close, if you're comfortable with that, and imagine a situation that happened this last week, okay, or so. If you have to go further back, then that's fine, but I'd rather have it be fresh in your mind. And I want you to imagine a time where you felt irritated or frustrated. Maybe it happened today. Maybe it happened earlier in the week. But really conjure up the memory of, it could be full-blown anger. Guess maybe let's not start with your hardest angry thing. Start with something a little softer maybe, but if you're super angry right now about something and that's what's here, bring it up. It's fine. It's here. It's already here. Imagine the situation. Imagine the people involved, the smells, the sounds, the visual. Like, bring in all your senses to really imagine the scene that you're angry about or you were angry about. Let your mind get into the story of it, because we want to really allow ourselves to bring up the bodily sensations. And it's unpleasant. I realize I'm asking you to do something unpleasant, but it's with a purpose. If you're having a hard time coming up with something recently, maybe an old anger, maybe a resentment that you've been holding on to, doesn't have to be recent. Okay, now I want you to allow your arms to raise up overhead. Deep breath and breathe out. Next in breath. On the out breath, I want you to imagine yourself letting go of the story. Whatever story is attached to this angry thing that happened or this anger that you're holding on to, just imagine the story. You're letting go of the story every time you breathe out. In fact, if you're in a place where you can stand easily, stand up. Anger is an active emotion, okay? Get in your body, okay? You're angry, right? With the next out breath, we're gonna do E. E. Open, but not focused on me, just focused on something neutral. Feeling the emotion of anger, dropping the story and making the sound. Drop the story, drop the thoughts. We're going to do a motion that's very associated with anger and Vajra energy. It's like a sword chop, okay? So you're going to turn sideways. Left foot forward, right foot back. Okay, so we're gonna breathe in, bringing your sword up. Breathing out, E. E. Imagine you're cutting through delusion, you're cutting through everything unclear. in the story so that you could be skillful. Clear-cutting wisdom. Soft knees, eyes closed or open, but soft. Check in. What's here now? How are you in your body right now? Tuning into the breath. Noticing, is there a difference from before the toning and the movement and after? Again, maybe there's not. We're not creating anything, we're just noticing, just experimenting with our own awareness. Slowly opening the eyes, but staying inward. Staying inward with the eyes open, soft. And just shifting from one foot to the next. Feeling the feet grounded into the earth. Really here. Here in your body. Thoughts come and go. No big deal, no problem. They're just thoughts. They're just coming and going like clouds drifting across the sky. And slowly, mindfully, in your body, finding your seat. And allowing your eyes to close. Shifting around, if you're not sure if you've checked your cell phone, you can turn that off. Silence it. And just really getting comfortable. Really finding a place of stability. Upright. Spine relaxed. As if there's a string from the top of your head up into the sky, just kind of pulling that spine upwards. And coming to focus on the breath. Picking a spot. Noticing today, is it easiest to be aware of your breathing at the nose, maybe the tip of the nose? Perhaps the bridge of the nose where the air passes by that uppermost spot. Maybe you feel it in the back of your throat where the air moves past that part. Maybe today you're most aware of your lungs expanding, the skin stretching over your ribs, and then the lungs softening. Or maybe you're most aware of belly breathing today. If you expansion of the belly with the in-breath, and then the softening of the belly, the navel moving towards the spine, towards the back body, and the out-breath. So just tuning in, seeing where does my awareness rest most easily today on the breath? Noticing if you're holding your jaw or your mouth tightly. We often hold a lot of tension in our jaw and our mouth. So with the next in-breath, bringing awareness to that area of your face. And with the next out-breath, inviting the mouth and the jaw to soften, maybe even just letting your jaw hang for a moment. Just allowing the face to be loose, soft. So much easier to meditate when we're not holding our bodies tightly. Imagining that you can expand this softness outward just with the whispering of the word soften. So with each in-breath, imagine that there's like a sphere of awareness in your mouth area. Okay, it's like a bubble. It's like a spherical, clear, almost like a soap bubble. And inside that bubble, everything is soft and fluid and relaxed and warm and easeful, very easeful. So you breathe in energy into your bubble, and when you breathe out, you whisper the word soften. It's an invitation, not a command. You invite your body to soften, invite the face to soften, and then with the next in-breath, the bubble expands a little bit, and now your whole head, your entire head, is in the bubble. So you breathe into the bubble, and when you breathe out, soften. The eyes, the eyebrows, forehead, chin, cheeks, the whole face just melts like butter. All the while, the awareness of the breath is there. It's like your anchor. Still anchored to the breath. It's this gentle swaying of the breath. Resting in a hammock. It's this gentle in and out, very soothing. Next in-breath, the bubble expands to include your neck and your shoulders, a place we hold a lot of tension. Maybe even just to bring awareness to how much those muscles are probably already firing. Take a moment and actually like scrunch up your whole face and your shoulders, like make a funny face. And then release. It's a good way to release resting muscle tension. So do that a few more times on your own if that felt good. Bring up your shoulders to your ears. If you want, make a funny face, scrunching up all your face muscles and tightening those neck muscles, really contracting. And then softening. Do this a few more times if you want to, or just sit in awareness of the breath, whatever you need right now. And then moving the awareness, or expanding the awareness bubble rather, to include the chest and the arms. And flexing the arms, so making fists, flexing the biceps, squeezing so that you can feel what contraction feels like, because we hold so much resting tension. And then releasing. And that way you can feel when the muscles are really turned off. Just noticing sound. So we're all aware of the baby. Noticing if you have a reaction. Maybe it's like a, oh, how sweet. Maybe it's a, oh, how annoying. Doesn't matter. Okay? Drop the judgment. Causes and conditions. Okay? That's why you had whatever reaction you had to the noise of the baby. Drop the judgment. Be aware, did I have a reaction in my body to the sound of the baby? Everything's a meditation, guys. Everything. Just being aware of what's already here. We don't have to eliminate sound. We can't. So maybe one or two more times of flexing your arms. Bring in the chest and the belly this time. Really flexing the abdomen, flexing your pecs, your chest muscles. Tight, 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 and then release. Doing that as many more times as you want. Thank you.
I'm going to go to the next one. 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 I'm going